All right, hey guys, what's up? V8 Merc here. Want to take you guys on a new project that we got going on here. We're making a backstop for our shooting escapades. So we're working on that back towards the end of our property. And I was going to hop on my horse here and go check out our progress. I couldn't show you guys yesterday. It was really windy. Even today, it's a little too windy to go out there, but I'm going to try my best to actually show you guys from beginning to end. And, I'm going to make it. It's going to be a one-piece video, as you'll obviously see. But let's go on and head on back there. And I'll have to pause you guys because you guys don't want to be, like, in the wind. It's really windy outside. And then on the motorcycle, it's going to be even more windier. So I'll see you guys back there. All right, so we just made it back. I'm gonna hold the camera up a little bit closer to my mouth so you guys can hear me talk. And here, what you're seeing is, well, this is all wet right now. This is all flooded, or was flooded. And what we did was we cleared out this whole area, all this debris right here. This is a hard pan from the field, cement. Extra cement that we had, like when we were building stuff around the property, like we built this landing to this bridge. So extra cement we just poured over here because there's no need for it anywhere else. So we had to clear out all that, then kind of like level the ground. And we had lots of this loose powdery dirt, like just, this is mainly ash because what they do is they burn brush piles here. And we used to do that too. We don't have brush anymore. So most of this is just ash and dirt mixed. So we had to push that into this area because we wanted to get rid of it.
Holy shit.
Birds just came right at me. Birds are hella fast. Anyways, so yeah, we pushed a bunch of this fine powdery dirt into the center, and then we wanted to water it so we can compact it. And we're gonna actually bring some more dirt in and build a pad, raise the pad to about like the level of the water, right about there, maybe even a little bit higher, not that high, but like about right there. Build a pad for the whole backstop that we want to make. And so we just want to do that and compact the ground. That's why it's all wet right now, so we can do that and also keep the dust down. So that's what we're working on as a project for the next, I don't know how many weeks. I'll let you know at the end. But the whole point here is just to make it safer for us to shoot, so that we can have like a backstop. And you guys will see next time we come around, we will be putting in the dirt, or I probably will already have the dirt in, depends if I can get the camera out or not. Because when you're working, you can't bother the other people by not working and messing around with the camera, so you gotta do that. So next time you see it, it'll probably be filled with dirt, or someone will be on the tractor filling it with dirt. Probably me. Alright guys, see you in a little bit. Alright guys, back again, and I'm driving this front end loader over this bridge. I don't know if you guys can hear me. Probably not the safest thing to do, record and drive this big old tractor, but I thought I'll pick up one load with you guys and show you what it's like working on this thing. very dangerous right here. I think I got a full load on that one. Yep, got a full load. All right, let's head on back. There's a couple of scary things when you're driving this thing. One is going back over that bridge right over there. The other thing is running over your dog, which is what I'm more worried about, because I don't want to hurt my dogs. But they seem to stay out of the way. There's my dad's over there. He's spreading out the dirt that I'm dumping. Dog's already used to all these tractors, so she ain't gonna really move unless she has to. Soft, right? It's soft. Yeah, where we watered it, it's really soft. And he's compacting it with the tires. This thing is way heavier. I can compact with this, but these tires are kind of bald and it might get stuck, and then we might not be able to pull it out. Let's find out where he wants the dirt. Yeah. That's really soft. Dogs. Oh yeah, you know what? We're gonna have a lot of extra dirt. So, okay. I gotta go around the roadblock. Another scary part, we just rebuilt this bridge. So it's pretty strong, but still, you never know. safety reasons, I'm gonna have to get back to you guys in a little bit. So I'll see you in a little bit. All right, so it's breezy again, but we're just flattening it out, spreading around the dirt that I brought. We're not done yet. We just hit a pretty big snag because we blew off the transmission line on this thing. These guys are just, I don't know why they're sitting in the bucket. I'd expect them to be afraid of it. They're not afraid of it anymore. But see the spray. The oil line came off on this thing right up there. It's still pretty hot, still dripping. But I lost steering. You could tell it was really hard. And then it wouldn't go forward or back. This is automatic, obviously. I don't have to shift gears, so it uses fluid like in a car. And the steering on this one uses hydraulic rams, not an actual steering pump, so it's different. So it actually pivots on an axis. But nonetheless, tractor's out of commission, so we're done for the day. And here's the scene where it completely lost all of its blood, basically, because it can't move without this fluid. So you could say it's like its blood, kind of. Right about here, took a shit. So that's where we're at for now. When we get it back and running, we'll be on our way, and I'll show you guys the next part to it. See you in a little bit. Back again, guys, and it's still a little bit breezy, but got that nice California sun beating down. Feels really good. So here's where we are right now. In the last bit, you saw the tractor break down, got that fixed. We finished filling this up with dirt, troweled it out with the other tractor, and I compacted it down with the loader using the wheels. Very heavy tractor, compacted it down very well. You can see how much dirt we ended up putting in. Compare this to the very first video clip, and you can see in relation to the pipe how much dirt we put in. I'd say it was just over a foot, and it's pretty much leveled out. We're gonna have to level it out just a little bit more, as far as where we're gonna put the ties down. And here you can see we wetted it down where we will be digging. We're gonna be digging to put some poles down to support the structure so it doesn't collapse or fall to the side with all the dirt that's gonna be in here. As you can see, we got the basic shape made out, and we got our shipment of railroad ties right over there. These suckers are heavy. These were about 4 feet tall, stacked, and we had to lay each one of these out and measure them because they're not exactly the length that they said they are. They're supposed to be 14 feet, and they're actually plus one, plus half inch, plus 1.5 inch, plus 2 inches. Sometimes that means that they're 14, 14-1, 14-2. So they're a bit longer, and so we had to lay them all out, and they're about like 300 pounds a piece, I'd say. We had to carry them out there, and I actually ended up laying one beam this way, and then we flopped them onto this, and I had to roll them out. A lot of work yesterday trying to do that. And it's just to see what we need, which ties are going to make it to the back wall. You can't have misaligned ties in the back. You'll have dirt falling out, and the structure won't be as nice as it probably could. So we have to do that. Hold on, let me get out of the wind. So, a lot of ties. I want to say it's like 25 or 30. Not too sure. But yeah, that's $1,000 worth of wood. Doesn't look like it, but it is. And we were fortunate enough to have a railroad yard here that, they pick up the ties and all the stuff. And they're local here. I heard there's only a few places in California. I'm not sure about that. So that's our wood. Here's our basic shape. And I'll try to pull out the camera for you guys while we're working on this. And I'll show you guys that in the next bit. Back again. Here we have the poles put in. These are 4x4 by 10 feet long treated poles or posts. We dug down 30 inches for each one. very hard. I haven't dug post holes for a long time, but got through it, and we dug 15 of them. There's 15 poles. They're spaced out about 3 feet apart, about 3 feet or so, and each one of these had two to two and a half bags of concrete put in them. That post concrete, you know, you just put it in the hole and you mix it with water. That's all that you have to do with that type of concrete. And so they have at the minimum two. Most of them have about 2 1/4 bags of concrete. And then I think a few of them actually got 2 1/2, just because they got wider. So here you can see all these. Did it all in one day. The digging was done in a previous day, but this is it's been about 2 days since the last time I showed you guys this, since the last video clip you just saw. And this is the actual structure we're going to start with. And here, let me get a few steps back and you can see what it's going to start to look like. And that's actually pretty tall, pretty big. This is going to be about 7.5 feet tall. 10 ties up, and there's 7 inches wide. So we're going to start, I think we're going to start stacking them today by hand, and then we're going to get to the point where we can't do it anymore by hand, and we're going to have to bring a forklift, and then we'll go from there. But I'll try to bring out the camera for you guys and show you that too. So here we are right now. This is how far we got before I could pull out the camera, because we're going on a little break. And we put, let's see, how many did we put? 1, 2, 3, 4. Up to here, we did that by hand. Up to here, we have to carry these by hand right here. So we have to stack those using three guys. And then the next three layers that we just put were done by this forklift tractor thing. I guess it used to be a tractor, then they converted it to a forklift. Pretty tricky to drive, and we're going to try to show you guys me lowering it. It's going to be really hard, so I'm going to have someone else film it, not me, because I can't control the camera and the steering and forward back and the load or the hydraulic all at the same time. It would be just too complicated. And here we're bolting up, made the holes to put bolts in them. And here are the bolts that we're using. I got the bolts right here. These are 8-inch 3/16 bolts that we're putting through. Thank you.
No. Let me get on the other.
So here we're done. We completely stacked all the wood, and we lined the inside with plywood, the cheaper kind, to insulate the cracks from the dirt so that dirt doesn't leak out. And then we also sprayed foam to seal up all the cracks so dirt doesn't get between the wood. And we're going to line it with this paper to protect the plywood from the dirt so it doesn't deteriorate and fall apart. And we're going to put these tires in front when we start putting in the dirt, and we're going to do that in a little bit. So here we finished wrapping it with the tar paper that's used on roofs, and like I said, it's to protect it from the dirt. And now we've stacked our tires here, and we're going to fill these with dirt, and then we're going to start filling this up with the big tractor. We got a bunch more tires, and we're going to go about 3 tires high. And from 3 tires high, then we're going to start the slope up towards the top. And the reason why we have the tires in the front is so when you're shooting into the, well, a little dust storm there. When you're shooting into towards the bottom part, so that it just doesn't crumble. And it will start the slope up. Wow, a lot of dust there. It'll start the slope higher, allowing us to keep more dirt up there, so it'll be thicker up here. So it'll be like 6 feet thick here, and then hopefully about 2 feet thick up here. And there's less chance of us shooting up there, more towards the middle. But if there's a ricochet or scatter going up there, the dirt should stop it, plus the tie in the back. So now we're gonna get the dirt and start filling it up. So we got to pick up a load here. It's kind of hard to drive and film for you guys, but I'm trying my best. Oh, there's a log in there. Shit. Request was made that this dirt be soft, so I gotta beat up the dirt a little bit. That should do it. so that they don't, like, the tires don't move around and whatnot. So it's a more rigid structure. That bridge is scary to drive over. I'm still kind of nervous, but it's held up so far. Cut you guys off for a little bit. I gotta switch positions with my brother and let him drive around for a bit and make me go do some real hard work. So I'll show you guys a little in a little bit. And here's the finished product. It's a little windy, so bear with me. So, last time I told you guys that we had three tires. Three layers, but we actually went with a fourth layer with these super wide tires. And the reason for that was because our slope wasn't correct. We didn't have the correct angle that we wanted. So we had to put in a fourth row and start the slope from there. And so we have a 2 foot thickness, over 2 foot. It's about 2.5 to almost 3 feet thickness at the top to help protect. And that was just an insurance thing for us. So we also completed the roof too. Couldn't show much of that because it was really hard to do that, but it's just a bunch of 2x4 runners going across and then some 2x6 connectors, or laterals. And these 2x6s are also holding the sidewalls together as well. But I don't see any problems with that because our outside structure, which I'm going to show you in just a second, but it's going to be really windy, so hold on. The outside structure is pretty strong with all these 4x4s. And you may have noticed the gap all the way around the edge, and that's just so wind can escape when it comes in here. But I think we may have some problems with the dust blowing around, and we're just going to wait to see what happens with that. As well as the roof is flat right now, but we were thinking about putting a pitch to it, and we're not so sure yet. As time comes, we'll figure that out later. And there's only one more thing missing, and we want to put some kind of a pipe from here to the end to hang steel targets from. And we're not sure how we want to do that just yet, but this is where we're at so far. And when we do put it up, you'll just see it in my shooting videos, so just stick around for those. And I'm ordering some steel targets as well. So this is our shooting range, private shooting range, and we have up to about almost 400 yards, but we're probably going to be shooting mainly at 50 to 100. Once in a while, we may push it out past that, but that's not like a all-the-time kind of thing, because that's just not safe sometimes on a windy day. You got to be really careful when you're going to do something like that. So this is our private shooting range, and just want to show you guys from A to Z how we did it. If you guys have any comments, questions, anything like that, please leave them below. Also, please read the description for a price on how much it cost. The dirt tire was free for us. The dirt we had, the only thing we paid for was the wood. The labor was us. You know, the machinery, that was also provided for free by a friend. So, you know, I can estimate a cost, but I will give you a materials cost on what we put into it, and then a guesstimation on how much it probably would cost you to do the same thing without all the equipment that we had. So just look for that in the description below as well. All right, guys, so that's what I wanted to show you. V8 Merc, out.